stand. We follow the seasonal responsive as printed in your bulletin. You'll also be able to see all the words to the hymns and the liturgy and what the kids are saying tonight on the screen. Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
The light no darkness can overcome.
Stay with us, Lord, for it is evening.
And the day is almost over.
Be our light and scatter the darkness. In this Christmas season, it is our duty and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us, the Christ child lying in a manger. Let us read and learn in Holy Scripture the story of the loving promises of God from the first days after our fall into sin to the glorious redemption brought to us by this holy child. But first, let us pray.
Gracious Lord God, we pray for people all over the world who would delight with us to know the good news of Jesus Christ and who would join with us in singing his praises. Let us pray for the people of the world and for all those in our own congregation.
Heavenly Father, let us remember the poor and the helpless, the cold and the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who are sad, the lonely and the unloved, the elderly and the little children. We especially remember all those who do not know the Lord Jesus, or who do not love him, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love.
Finally, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us in heaven, who live in greater light than we, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, who died in faith, and who live before the throne of God and praise him each day in his temple. We confess that we are united with them as we are united with one another. Amen.
Please be seated. From now on, the congregation can follow along with the bulletin and also the words on the screen to see the direction of our service. We'll see hymn 46, Your Little Ones, Dear Lord Are We. The children will sing verse 1, congregation will sing verses 2 through 4.
Take their sin away so they no longer grieve. perfect world, free from all death and sin. But Satan tempted, be like God, and Eve had given in. God would have left them in their sin, or killed them there and then. Instead, he told them what he'd do to make them his again. Someday I'll send a special son whom Satan can't devour. He will be wounded for your sins and crush the devil's power.
Who has truly left his world?
David was the saintly born to live forever day. But this king would greatly suffer, the Psalms tell of his pain. God told Isaiah of the child whose brain would never see. He'd be born to the virgin girl and be the prince of peace. The Savior's suffering was foretold through prophecies revealed. He spared our sorrows and our grief, by his wounds he be healed. After all this preparation, the time was finally right for God to send his son to earth to die to make things right.
Thank you.
angel next appeared at night to shepherds guarding sheep. Out in a field near Bethlehem, while most folks were asleep, a dazzling light flashed in the sky, and angels came in sight. The shepherds looked and shook with fear, their eyes were wide as fright. "Don't be afraid," the angel said, "my news will bring great joy. Your Savior has been born today, a holy baby boy. You'll find him in a manger, and he's lying in some hay. The stable is in Bethlehem, not very far away." But the angels filled with the sky above, they sang a feast on earth, and praised the Lord for all he'd done, and for the Savior's birth.
Yeah. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria.
And everyone went to his own town to register.
Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, the town of David.
He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she brought to her firstborn son.
And she wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger,
and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying,
"Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all these things, pondered them in her heart.
The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
close our service this evening, ask you to rise and continue to follow in the responsive prayers. O gracious and almighty Father, we praise you that you kept your ancient promises by sending your everlasting Son in human flesh.
On this holy night, receive our thanks and devotion, our songs and prayers.
You sent Jesus as a lowly child to demonstrate your concern for all, the weak and the lonely, the troubled and frightened, the timid and helpless. No one is overlooked by your ever-seeking eyes. No one is excluded from your upholding arms. No one is denied the comfort and the help of your outstretched hand.
Bless us with a child of faith, in the divine assurance that you love and care for us always.
You sent Jesus as the Savior of the world to deliver all from the curse of sin, the power of death, and the torment of hell. He took our place. He was born under the law to set us free. He became the innocent lamb of sacrifice. He came to die and rise in order that we might live eternally. So firmly implant this good news in our hearts and fill us with an eager desire to spread the word concerning what we have heard tonight.
May all who hear the message and every nation under heaven be amazed.
You sent Jesus as the light of the world to drive out all darkness that would rob us of the full life that you intend for us. May the joy that will be for all people be our joy. May the peace on earth to all on whom his favor rests be our peace. And may the treasure that Mary pondered in her heart be our treasure.
For today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to us. He is Christ the Lord, and in his name we join to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
As the angels sang out their praise, move us also to sing out our praise to you, today and every day, so that the joy of Christmas may remain in our hearts, and may the peace of the Savior's birth fill our hearts with joy. The love of God motivate us to live for our Savior, and the gift of the Holy Spirit be with us always.
To bless the world with peace.